Well, fairly or unfairly, social media of late has been getting more than the occasional bad rap. Most recently, for instance, we saw Twitter and Facebook being used to organise so-called flash mobs during the London riots. Worldwide, governments are actually considering IT blackouts when social media becomes decidedly antisocial. Here's Emma Dalymore.
Just got like an expert flash mob. Punch in the face for no reason.
Across London, the Middle East, and America.
For justice, for peace!
Flash mobs are a puzzling phenomenon,
converging on stores and in streets to rob and terrorise people. What is going on?
Frightening for bystanders, almost impossible for police to prepare for. In Maryland, 24 people were in and out of a 7-Eleven in 60 seconds. A flash rob with staff powerless to intervene. It's now estimated that a staggering 1 in 10 American retailers has been hit with flash mob violence.
If you are under the age of 18 years old, your curfew is now 9 p.m. on Fridays and Saturdays.
That's Philadelphia's response after a number of recent mob attacks, while in San Francisco...
No justice, no peace, disband our police.
Totalitarian states don't want people to communicate.
The local transit authority shut down the mobile phone network in city train stations, their answer to stop social organising after protesters, angered over a police shooting, ground peak hour traffic to a halt.
What BART did was a violation of our free speech rights. If the First Amendment means anything, it means that the government should not be in the business of shutting down the free flow of information.
Given that it is their equipment, they probably have a pretty good argument that they're allowed to do that.
The original flash mob concept began innocently enough. Calls for spontaneous dance or song via social media. Such a big part of pop culture, even phone companies are marketing it.
We are!
Got it.
Don't be the last to know.
But that same principle is now being applied with anti-social motives, leaving police agencies scrambling to find ways to fight back. In the UK, Britain's Prime Minister has flagged similar technology blackouts after suggestions BlackBerry Messenger was used to coordinate rioting mobs.
I think it's quite clear that the issue of social media, that's been so much of the issue in London's riots recently, is going to have to be explored much more closely by government, media, the public, that if it's found that it's really contributing to the spread of violence.
And even when there's no physical violence. An American rapper was investigated after rallying 500,000 Twitter followers to flash call an LA police station. They swamped the line, leaving real calls unanswered.
Definitely send my sincerest apologies to, you know, the sheriff's department. And like I said, it was just a joke going wrong.
Globally, no police force seems to see it that way, as they continue to search for the right balance between public safety and freedom.
Welcome to the not-so-brave new world, I'd say.